bomb the media was, because one art form wasn't enough. Let's talk about Monster High. Because why not? Monster High is a line of dolls aimed at tween girls put out by Mattel and dates back to 2010. No dissimilar to something like Barbie, Bratz, or Equestria Girls. The big gimmick being different high school girls who are modeled after famous movie monsters, most of them in canon being the daughters of said horror icons. In a way, it's kind of like Ghoul School, except it isn't. I really don't have that much to say about this franchise since I didn't pay the best of attention to it. All I know is that it has a following, it's expanded beyond the toys with its animated specials, soundtracks, and written media, and I'll give it this, it's at least more creative than Bratz, which always came off as incredibly vapid to me. Though, from what I've seen, the animated movies in the series aren't as laughably bad as Mattel's Barbie movies, nor does it have the same kind of charm that Equestria Girls had. It's just kind of there. For those who want more on that, feel free to check out my buddy Razorblade's reviews of the Monster High movies when you get the time. Believe me, he goes into a lot of depth with those. But aside from all that, they've also had a couple of video games, most of which going straight to mobile. Except for today's review subject, Monster High Ghoul Spirit on the Wii. As always with a lot of these tie-in games, it was put out by THQ and was put together by a company called Backbone Entertainment, who have apparently been running from 2003 to 2015, with a lot of their titles being related to a bunch of different franchises, from animation to sports to a lot of classic game ports like Sonic, Paperboy, and Shinobi. This game being released in 2011, just a year after the initial boom of Monster High, it was released on the Wii as well as the DS. And apparently the DS version of this game is actually considered worse than the Wii version, so I guess we'll be looking at the good version of this game? Maybe? Well, let's actually play the game and see for ourselves. This is...
Nobody was doomed!
Hello, Toxic Dragonfly reviewer Razorblade? Oh, you're gonna help me review this game because...
What? No, I'm not gonna help you review this movie. I'm just glad that somebody else is reviewing Monster High instead of me. Good luck with that, bucko.
Alright then. Yeah, like I said, this is Monster High Ghoul Spirit for the Wii. Alright.
So here's the general plot of the game. You customize your playable character and wander around the school, talk to people, and they give you a bunch of different mini-games and side quests. If this sounds familiar, it's because Bratz did something similar 6 years prior with Bratz Rock Angels. But I'll give this game some credit, there's more to it than just going into stores and putting on clothes. They at least give you a variety of different missions. As we begin properly in the hallways of the school with its pink and purple lockers that are shaped like mini coffins. So yeah, just work your way through the school from classrooms to the cafeteria and even the bathrooms, talk to people, and they'll give you some objectives. With missions including help Claudine the werewolf girl because another girl has the same outfit that she has.
Okay, well, I found Draculaura. Can she help me in any way?
OMG, we have to gab!
Oh, okay, great. I'm so glad we were able to bring an end to this horrible, world-ending calamity of someone wearing the same outfit that someone else was wearing.
Then there's missions involving Laguna, as she asks you to help bring her swim cap to her before swim practice. And then there's help Frankie Stein, who needs help reattaching her neck bolts.
Yeah. Ugh. You okay there, Ghoulia? Yeah, you're probably okay.
Basically, you just follow this bat around, as it serves as the arrow that you usually get in games like this, along with this map that represents the key locations as singular, brightly colored shapes. Yeah, at this point, you're better off just running into rooms at pure random, and just try to make sure you don't go into a room that has a mission you already did. Thankfully, this shouldn't be a problem, as you're given a diary where you can jot down missions that you finished. Mind you, this is a diary on a monster iPhone that they call an iCoffin.
iCoffin. You guys didn't even try with that one, did you? The thing with a lot of these missions is, it's just a lot of back and forth. Talk to one person, go to another, see if you can help get any information or resolve a mission that you're currently doing, or start a new mission. In between all of this comes these mini-games, because it's a Wii game, so of course there's going to be a lot of mini-games. Like this one, where you're helping the lunch lady prepare food like a knockoff cooking mama.
Or this one, where you're trying to recharge an MP3 player by using car batteries.
And naturally, like you'd come to expect from a Wii shovelware game, the controls in this are absolutely terrible. As I've brought up in other Wii game reviews before this, like Wonderworld Amusement Park, the controls are very bad. Or at the very least, the most basic and standard Wii motion controls. You're supposed to use the nunchuck, but you barely use it, so it doesn't really matter. When it comes to a lot of these mini-games, the controls you're usually going to be doing are either spam the A button or waggle the Wiimote around. Whether it's slowly, like in the cafeteria minigame, or waggle it vigorously as possible, like in the car battery one. And if it isn't that, then it's make sure that the Wiimote is lined up with the TV properly so the character doesn't get stuck. Yeah, I think that goes to show how much of a failure Wii motion controls were, right? Just make sure that the remote isn't too far away from the TV, or you might not be able to play the damn game. It certainly isn't help with the lag in certain parts of the game. It feels like when there's a certain amount of characters or objects on screen, the game just starts lagging like crazy. I'm not sure if this is my copy of the game specifically or some kind of glitch, but it gets distracting really fast. So that was Monster High Ghoul Spirit for the Wii, and it was exactly what I was expecting it to be. Unless you're a huge fan of this franchise, you could otherwise give this game a skip. The mini-games are on par with mediocre online flash games, the missions themselves are just a lot of running around and resolving such pressing issues like not wearing the same thing that someone else is. The controls are exactly what I was expecting from a Wii shovelware title. The graphics are okay, I guess, for this type of game. I've certainly seen worse CG conversions in games like this. The biggest problem I could find is that, even for its target demographic of young girls, this game comes off as boring half of the time, with all the running around that you're gonna do. Besides, you can just eat a bunch of Halloween candy, get a sugar high, and run around your house for about half an hour, and it would be more exciting. And yet, with all that being said, it's still not the most boring game I've ever reviewed. No, that probably still goes to South Park on N64. And that's part of a franchise that I like, and yet Monster High still came off less boring. Not by much, but still.
So yeah, unless you're a diehard fan of Monster High, I'd say skip this game. Although it does make me wonder how bad the DS version was compared to this. Whatever. I'm a media whiz, because one art form wasn't enough.